In our layout editor series, we will look at how to create our 2D deliverables from a 3D model in Allplan, focusing specifically on generating the drawing sheets. In this first video, we will look at how to create a cover page. You can see for this project, the views and sections have already been generated. Let's open the building structure by clicking on the icon or double left clicking on the viewport. In the building structure, you can see I have the model broken up into different drawing files by objects and reinforcing. On the right, under the Derived From section, I have the views and sections each on their own drawing file. In the model, use the Objects palette to filter by drawing files and manage the project. Here we can turn on or off the visibility of drawing files to see how views are arranged. This is a great tool at any step of the modeling process. Now we're ready to go into the layout editor. This is where we will build our drawing sheets. To start, click on the Setup Page command. Here we define the page size, margins, and title block. You can save your own company title block to load here. In this case, I saved my title block as a label, so I must first add a border. And I will put it around the perimeter so that it won't be printed. Next, I can click on the label option and select my company label from the office folder. You can create your own company labels here. Information for your cover page, such as general notes, logos, or other information can be saved to the library, and these can then be easily pulled into the cover sheet as needed. Double-click on the saved item in the library and place it in the sheet. These should be saved to full-size scale when in the model. Once added here, these are editable and can be changed for the given project. Just double-click on them to edit them. Another thing we can do is create custom labels that pull project information onto the cover sheet. And to do this, we must first add a border around the page. Again, we can set this to be hidden by creating the border width and height equal to the page size and using a white color. Now we can click on the label command in the ribbon. Then you must click on that border that you just added. Now we can choose a label from the office folder, and these are custom labels that you need to create yourself. I've previously created this label for my cover sheets that includes the project name, client, and client address. So I can select it and place it here on the sheet. The next thing we can do is create a table of contents, and we can do this via a link with Excel. So first I'm going to show the menu bar. Now in the Insert drop-down menu, I'm going to click on Object. I have previously saved an Excel template of how I want my table of contents to look. I can now load that template. This will save a copy of the template for this project, and it will not override my original. Once it's placed in the model, I can double-click on it to make changes, and this will automatically open Excel. I can then make the changes that I need in Excel. I can save the file, and then once I close it and go back to Allplan, you can see that the table automatically updates in Allplan. Finally, let's see how we can modify the project data to fill in the title block and that custom label. In the ribbon, go to the Layout Attributes command. Here we can see all of the layouts in the project and also assign information to them individually. At the bottom of this screen, we have the project attributes. Now I have previously saved a template with generic names in the project attributes that I'm using. That way I can filter by attributes that are in use to make it easier to change for each project. I can now put this information for the project as needed. And once I close and apply the changes, the labels and the title block will update with this new information. I've now completed the title page, and that completes this first video on generating drawing sheets.